right. Today's the day. We are finally recreating our own version of these incredible, sparkly, beautiful, glorious, glamorous statement heels. I have had them screenshot in my folder forever, and I went down a crazy, crazy rabbit hole of just looking at everything that this amazing brand designs. They are so cool and so talented. And the reason that I love doing this actually as a DIY is that you can take this really cool crystal trim rope and create these designs on any shoe that you want. So if you are not a big high heel person and you don't have an opportunity to wear crazy high heels like this and you want to put them on a pair of low ankle boots or a pair of flip-flops or a pair of slides or sneakers, you can do this to anything. And that's why DIY is so awesome, is that you can make it completely personal to you. So we are taking tons of inspiration from this incredible brand, and I can't wait. I have everything that you're gonna need linked below. So number one, you can use shoes that you already own, obviously. However, the crystal trim in all its different widths, Benjamin, our man Benjamin, has all of it. Not only does he have lots of different colors, but he also has lots of different sizes. So if you wanna do the shoelace style on a pair of like sneakers or something like that, or you wanna do the big thicker style for the bows, he has everything that you need, and I'll link straight to his Etsy page. I'm really excited. I wanna thank Skillshare for supporting me and making today's video possible. They are sponsoring this one. If you have never heard of Skillshare, guys, it is an incredible online community where millions of creatives come together every day to either learn something completely new or maybe to like deepen their knowledge in something they know a little about. It has been such a great resource during the pandemic because people have been able to educate themselves and start completely brand new businesses during this time, which is so amazing. I do have a link down below, and if you click the link, the first 1,000 of you are gonna get a free trial of premium. So let me show you how premium actually works. So I just typed in film editing into the top search bar, and it gives me a ton of options. I could go by beginner, intermediate, advanced, or just follow based off how much time I have. You're gonna see courses across film editing that cover every spectrum you could think of. Even this one, this is all about using a green screen. You'll see the amount of classes within that green screen will really give you everything you're gonna need to know to actually implement this. For example, I clicked in writing, which is something I'm really excited about. This is all about how to get published. Again, course by course is gonna have a breakdown of all the different classes and lessons you need. And of course, fashion design, everything from pattern making to business plans, it's really got you covered. So anyway, I love it so much. I can't recommend it enough. If you are a creative being like me, you are gonna absolutely love it. So again, the link below, first 1,000 of you to click it will get a free trial of Skillshare Premium. And then if you don't get the trial and the first 1,000 are already gone, it's only under $10 a month for all of Premium. So you guys could learn anything you want and bounce around as much as you want. Thank you all for being here. I can't wait for you to watch this video. It's so awesome. I hope you enjoy. Let's get into it.
All right, so to do this DIY, you are going to need a pair of heels that have a removable ankle strap. So all you're gonna do is take those straps and just pull them out, leaving basically a casing open to replace it. There are all different sizes of these that are gonna be linked below. This is the widest, and I'm definitely gonna use it for the bow, but it turns out it was too big to actually go through the ankle strap. So I grabbed the next size down, and it already had a stopper on it, which again was too big to go through the ankle strap. So you're gonna cut off the stopper, but make sure to give yourself about a half an inch so that you have some gripping to do to actually pull it out later, and you'll see that in just a second. Now you can see it fits really easily. You just kind of push it through all the way and then pull from the other side. Now here you go. You can see this is where I need to remove it because I want to put the end back on. You just pull with pliers, and you just need to make sure you give yourself that little tail so you have something to grab. Both of the ankle straps are in, and it's time to put the stopper back on. So a teeny bit of E6000 on either end, slowly push them inside the stopper, kind of twirl it around so the glue settles, and those are good to go. It's time to create the double bows. I wasn't exactly sure how I was gonna do this, but I'm gonna share my steps. I realized that a sort of figure eight was gonna create a nice shape of two little loops. We're gonna hide the center, so I'm just using some hot glue. I originally tried it with E6000, but it took so long to actually set up that I had to sit there and hold it forever. Hot glue is strong enough, especially because you'll see in a little bit, we loop something around it to hold it together. Once you have one done and pretty much dried, you're gonna make sure that you replicate that for your other shoe. So just use your first one as a guide for size. Now, I wanted to create that double bow that the inspo heels have. So at first I tried just looping it on the outside, but what happened is the center got really wide, which wasn't the right look. So instead, I decided to create another figure eight that was about 1.5 times as big. Now, when I layer them together, I still get that double bow look, but they stay nice and small in the center of the bow, which is what you want. I'm gonna be using some leftover crystal trim to actually clean up and hold together the center of the bow, but you could absolutely use this exact crystal rope material and just loop it around if you wanted. However, it is a pretty cool opportunity to add in a little extra sparkle. Once they were done, I obviously made a second one, and I wasn't 100% sold on it, so I work on another style of bow. I basically cut two pieces, and I loop them into the center in almost like to create like the shape of a B, or like the letter B, or like a butterfly wing or something like that. I looped them in, and I held them just like that, and then I do them back to back, just like this. And you'll see when I actually loop the trim around it, it smooshes them together in the middle, but it keeps the loops of the bow larger. You'll see this in just a second. I'm using the crystal trim to wrap it around. Again, the bows going opposite each other. And you see how on the left, the loops are just like larger. I tried them on a few different things, and ultimately that's the version I liked. So at first I thought, okay, I'm just gonna glue it on. I did hot glue. Then I thought, no, that's probably not enough. Let me add some E6000. The E6000 will hold it long-term. Didn't like that either. So I peeled off as much of the glue as I could, and I ended up using clear thread and a needle. So all I did is go through it once, and then I like loop and loop. I'm not even stitching it. I'm just tacking it down by looping around either side of that crystal trim. Once one side is done, I go through the heel and that's tacked down that side. Then I move to the other side of that little crystal trim in the middle and I do the same thing. You're just gonna knot it off in the back, cut it off, and basically these are done. I wanna show you guys this really fun red version. So we've got one little bonus. Here it is, same heels. Again, pull out the ankle strap in the back and replace it with the crystal. This was the red on red, and so this is the large, and this particular heel, that size was fine. Large worked perfectly. These are some awesome magnetic snaps that Benjamin had, and I decided to use it for this version. So what I did is put on the shoe and wrapped it around my ankle. I bent my ankle a bunch to sort of feel how tight I could get away with doing it without the magnets popping. Cut it at that length, and then just cut the second heel to be the same. Now, the ankle straps are done, and I'll add the magnets in just a second. It's time to do this part. There's a rope that goes around the front of the shoe. Now, in order to do it, I'm gonna cut the rope almost in half. Not quite in half. You can see one side is about 2/3 and the other is about 1/3. What it's gonna do is it's gonna look like it's the full rope, but the backside will be flat, which means it's gonna lay much better and it's gonna hold much better. So you're gonna put tiny scissors in and just basically cut it straight open all along one side. Once you go up all the way to the top, you're gonna move over like four little crystals and you're gonna be cutting again. Basically, this is cutting like four lengths of crystals out of it. I sat back and watched Grey's Anatomy.
Marcella Veronica's just been admitted to the hospital.
No, she was mild.
I know. Other symptoms became more pronounced.
You should time with her.
Fascinating stuff. All right, now you're gonna pull, boop, and there you go. We've basically got a flat back crystal rope that will be applied to this entire section. Add your E6000, grab your crystal rope, and just lay it really, really tight against the edge of the shoe on both the sole and the leather part of the shoe. You wanna make sure that everything is laying really close to that edge, and you need to hold it for quite a while to make sure that it actually dries. If you do wanna use a clothespin, make sure you're doing it in that little loop. See how it's got that curve? You wanna make sure to set it in that, otherwise the tension will actually like smush this stuff down and it can kind of distort the shape. So holding it is always best, but you can do gentle clips if need be. Now it's time to add those magnetic snaps. Again, all you're gonna do is add a little bit of glue. You can use E6000 or hot glue, whatever your little heart desires. Pop that sucker in and the magnetic snaps are done and ready to go. It's really cool when you see how they work, but making sure that the ankle strap is not too tight is key. Otherwise they will pop open. Okay, now it's time for the bows. I thought about adding these since I had made them, but I decided to go for the red instead. Now, just a disclaimer, the red does not sparkle in the same incredible way that the clear will sparkle, which you'll see at the end. It sparkles, it's cool, but it's not quite as intense as the clear or the rose gold, which you guys will see. Now, I just did large figure eight bows and I used the leftover of what I cut, you know, when I kind of cut the little guy in half to wrap the center. So this was made out of all the same material instead of a crystal trim like I did on the other. Now, I just glued this guy down, held it with some E6000, and we're done.
Okay, that's it. That's it. It is really easy and really fun. And as you can see, the options are endless. So I hope that you guys will do this to whatever pair of shoes speaks to you and fits in with your style and your life. I'm going to model them for you in a fun, frilly, fabulous little way. But again, I can't wait to see your versions. If you guys do this project, please, please tag me on social media at OrlyShani, pretty much everywhere. I cannot wait to see what you create. And if you loved this video, I hope that you will screenshot your phone or share it with a friend, post it on your social media and tag me. That would be so helpful. And if you're new, I hope you'll subscribe because I do great DIYs every single Friday and shorts on Sundays and Tuesdays. All right, guys, enjoy. We go to New Jersey. Your eyes sing, I'll be worried. You said he was nothing, but I know you get buried. The sorrow of us, the sorrow of us. How did we end up here? We used to laugh so hard. When did we stop loving, babe? When did it all go too far? Your reasons to yell.